My name is Colin Higgins. I'm 17 years old. I'm a senior here at Neuqua Valley, and I work in the auditorium doing lights and sound. Being the techie with the deepest voice, I get to do all the pre-show announcements, which is kind of cool. I get to write them up, but on a deep radio announcer voice, I don't know. Should I talk like this for my entire interview? Hello, ladies and gentlemen. The first thing we teach all the new techies is actually a list of the things you can't touch. Is that about right? I think fly rails, anything having to do with sound initially, pretty much anything having to do with lights. The most dangerous part of the auditorium is the fly rail system. It's a counterbalance system comprised of an arbor and a bar. On the bar, we hang anything from backdrops to lights. And on the arbor is weight equal to what is on the bar. So that way it's easy for us to take things in and out, up and down on the stage. So we can, you know, light, have backdrops, and different set pieces are suspended. My favorite show of the year is V Show. I love just the size of the show. It's such a technical production. The sound and light side of things is just, it's immense. TV comes in, cameras, we make DVDs of the show, and with a school of 4,000 kids, we just have some great, great talent. And so it's guaranteed that whatever I'm doing sound for, it's quality, you know? It's fun and easy. Well, it's not necessarily easy, but it's guaranteed that whatever I'm doing sound for is fun, and it's just a quality performance. Right now for V-Show, we're renting our sound equipment from RJ Recording, which is the recording company that the music department uses. They've brought in a Midas, which is a European soundboard, subs, monitors, side fills, and front fill speakers, along with all the cabling needed, wireless microphones, any microphones needed, and really anything that has to do with sound, things like FX processors and gates, channels, any of the above. They brought it all. ILC, Intelligent Lighting Creations, is a company based out of Chicago. It's where we rent most of our lighting equipment from for V-Show. This year I think we've got four Vera Light 440s, four Mac 700s, eight Mac 301s. Just like I did. I mean, show up on your first day. I didn't even sign up. I just kind of showed up and said I wanted to do the show, and everybody here was very welcoming, very open. Immediately, just like hands-on, learn quick or die. Not really, but it was, you know, it was learn quick or fall behind. Hands-on learning right away. First day, they started teaching me things. It was great. All right, so someone new shows up. They want to do sound. I mean, obviously, I'm going to say rock on because I love it. I'll start with a tour. Show them where everything is. Tell them all the names of things, you know. And then we start with the path of a sound from the microphone through to the speaker and all the different things it goes through and travels through and the different controls you have over what comes out of the speaker as your end result. That's sort of like base one, lesson one. And then from there we expand. We talk about maybe patching in an auxiliary channel or EQing different types of voices. Everything from there to the separation between what a decibel and what a frequency is. So we really touch everything. And it doesn't take too long. A couple of days, you learn a lot. A lot of the basics. I've been doing it, this will be like 6 years now. that have really been doing sound seriously. That is, I learn something new every day. You know, how to better EQ an acoustic guitar. A little more of this makes a piano pop. That's, you know, I learn more every day, but it's been an ongoing process for, I've been doing it for 6 years now. But really, we've had kids who have run shows sound, and I've taught them. They've done it in a week. They've learned and run a show in a week. It's not, you know, you don't have to get too in depth for a lot of shows we do. Now, this show, that B show is obviously a little more involved, but like, I love it. But draws me the most, like keeps me coming back to the auditorium to work here every day is the environment. Because I know, regardless of what show I'm working on, that I'm gonna come in, I'm gonna get work done, but I'm gonna have a good time working with good people.